The Annotated Bibliography. Only academicians could take something so simple and turn it into 9 syllables of obscurity. What does an annotated bibliography actually mean? Actually, it's something quite simple, and let me show you. First thing we're going to do is to take out this N. Boink. And then the next thing we're going to do is to take out the TED. Boink. And that leaves us with a nota. That's right, a nota. Flip that A upside down and you have a note. That's all that an annotation is, a note. What is it a note about? Let's take a look at the next word, bibliography. First thing we're going to do is get rid of the ography. We know what that means. It's having to do with something with writing, autobiography, writing about yourself, discography, writing about a musician's works, etc. So let's get rid of ography. Boink. Now, that leaves us with bibli. Bibli, that sounds awfully familiar. Where have I heard that word before? Let's see, it's the Latin word for book. That's right. In France and Spain, they call libraries and bookstores bibliothèques. As a matter of fact, the first book ever published in Europe was called the book, or the Bible, the bibli. Now sometimes called the good book, as well as simply the book. After all, why not call it the book? It was the only one for a very long time. So, all an annotated bibliography is, notes about a book. Now, books come from the days of yesteryear, back in the day. Today, of course, we have magazines, online and print, journals, online and print, websites, social media, all of which we can make notes about. And whenever we make notes about those things, we're making an annotated bibliography. So that's what an annotated bibliography is. It's something simple. But what I want to talk to you about right now is the reasons why, other than a teacher telling you to, the reasons why you should do an annotated bibliography. Now, it turns out there are some very good reasons. First and foremost, to learn to do it better. You see, you probably already compose informal annotated bibliographies for the purchases you make. If you're in the market for a new mobile phone or computer, you look up the different models, read about them, make a few notes about what you like, maybe even copy and paste a review. All of the select quote services available today are based on the idea that you let someone else compile an annotated bibliography for you. You then read about the different services or products, their pros and cons, their prices, and you make your choice. So, you see, doing an annotated bibliography is usually the first step in any research that you do, whether personal or formal in school. The big difference is that in school, the topics and the ideas that you're dealing with are more complex, more involved. So, the annotations that you have to write need to be more structured, more methodical, and more detailed. So let's take a look at some of the things that you must keep track of on this new level. First, you have to keep track of what you found. This is descriptive information. You have to keep track of where you found it. That is citation information. And you have to keep track of what value it has for you, and that's critical information. These are the same goals as select quote, but you're doing them more formally. Next, what purposes does the annotated bibliography serve, whether it's about the latest computer tablet or the effects of the modern Russian mafia on America's economy? First, an annotated bib is a database. In other words, during your research, you compile into one place the actual information you will use. You need this database before you can begin planning your document or even writing it. Second, it's a diary. In an annotated bib, you talk to yourself about what you found. Did you find a major concept or argument that takes you into a new direction? Or did you find hogwash? Did you find the exact quote you want to illustrate a main point? Did you find the stats you need to establish the problem? You see, in a diary, you react to what happens to you during your life. In an annotated bib, you react to the materials that you find. Third, it's an accelerator. A good annotated bib coupled with a good outline means that the writing will almost take care of itself. You've gathered and digested all the information you need. Then, during the writing, you won't have to refine sources because you've kept good, accurate citation information. Okay, now that you know more about what an annotated bibliography is and what it does, in the next video, we're going to take a look at a sample annotation and break it down into its component parts so that you can reproduce it for your own annotated bibliography. Okay, see you in the next video.